So hello everyone and very good afternoon to all of you. Thanks again for joining our webinar on this new topic here, inventory valuation and the cost of the sales. So we will beginning our webinar right now. In the meanwhile, I just again request you, is my voice is audible to you? Can you reply on the chat box? Please reply on the chat box, is the screen is visible to you and my voice is audible to you? Okay, thanks. I'm getting the confirmation here from the audience. So, okay, we will just go ahead. Now, most very important topic we have taken here, that is the inventory valuation, because many users comes and they comes with a very difficulties in facing here regarding the inventory valuation as Tally, what it gates our valuation, whether the valuation goes correct or accurate, and in what way it gives us the valuation or it values the stock. So it's very important here. So we will be learning here the inventory valuation method in Tally.ERP 9. Okay, so let's start here. Now, there are the different stock valuation methods here. We will be learning what are the different stock valuation method, okay, and basically how Tally helps us in the valuation method. So is my voice is audible to you? Can you reply on the chat box, because I'm getting some negative response that it's my voice is not audible. Okay, thank you. Now it's audible to you. So Tally.ERP 9 basically allows to value the stock in different methods. Each stock item can be set up to have the different stock valuation method. And these two are the valuation method which are important in Tally. Number first, valuation is based on the cost of the product. And basically secondly, valuation is based on the market price of the product. But if you see here the fundamentals of the accounting, it says that the cost of the or the closing stock should be valued at the cost or the market value, whichever is the lower. But right now that fundamental in Tally, we cannot achieve that. But Tally gives all the complete valuation methods with a different valuation method so that the user can do it with the different valuation method. And basically it is nothing but the cost of the product. It's very important here. In Tally product here or in Tally perspective, if you see here, we get the two method or we get the two option, that is a costing method and second is a market valuation method. But Tally calculates the valuation on the basis of the costing method. So very important here. So if you're doing from Tally valuation, you have to see that you have properly selected the costing method here, which are the different valuation method we will be learning here. And it's very important here. So while beginning the company or while selecting the company, it is very important that the company should select the proper costing method or with what we can say is a proper stock valuation method. Now, they are the very important here as per the accounting standard, if you follow, they are the two valuation method, which basically most of the companies follow it or mandated. Number first, that is a FIFO valuation, and second one, what we can say as the weighted average cost, or what we can say is a average cost. Okay, so it's very important here that the company follows here two method here. Okay, so it's very important. There are the different two stock valuation method which are mostly the companies are following. That is, first is the FIFO and second is the weighted average cost. Now, here we'll be going here different stock valuation method. So if you see the Tally screen, you get this list of the different stock method. Okay, so we'll be learning here different stock method here. The first is what we can say the zero cost. So this valuation will be very useful in case of, like, suppose you have created the services item in Tally ERP 9, let's say like installation or assembling or any servicing product or repairing or AMC. And for that, we don't need any valuation to be reflected in the books of the accounts. Then you can select it at a zero cost. So it's very important here where that zero cost is very important. Similarly, in case of fixed assets, you can select at a zero cost. Because the fixed assets valuation, we don't need it to be reflected in the profit and loss account. Though you have created the inventory as a fixed assets, but you do not need the valuation to be reflected in the profit and loss account. The second is the weighted average cost or the average cost, which is nothing but the total inward quantity divided by, the total inward value divided by the total inward quantity, which is what we can say is the average cost. So please keep in mind, the average cost can be calculated as the total inward value divided by the total inward quantity. Now we have the FIFO, that is first in, first out. So what it will be the first if you have purchased. So if you have sold something, so that from selling quantity, the first what we have purchased, that has to be taken into the consideration, and the rest will be your closing stock. So that is the FIFO method. Similarly, FIFO perpetual, it's very important. What is the difference between FIFO and the FIFO perpetual? Many times the user selects the FIFO, but we recommend to select the FIFO perpetual, because in case you are having the stock in the opening balances, the rate quantity in the opening stock, then that rate also has to be considered for the FIFO valuation. So we recommend them to select the FIFO perpetual. Even suppose you don't have any opening stock, but suppose in the second year you are splitting the company data and then the data gets continued, then it's very important here that the user should select the FIFO perpetual. The rest working is the same as like the FIFO, but the FIFO perpetual considers the rate as been mentioned in the opening also. So in the opening stock, if you have mentioned quantity, rate and amount, that also it considers here. Then we are talking about the last purchase cost, which is nothing that whatever the last purchase you have done, that also the cost should be considered. So many companies are following that last purchase cost also. Then we have the LIFO annual, that is the last in, first out. Then the LIFO perpetual, same as like we have explained in the FIFO and FIFO perpetual, same like last LIFO and LIFO perpetual, which will work opposite as compared to the FIFO. Then we will be going through the standard cost. So it's very important, the standard cost. Suppose some companies are following the standard costing. Their purchase cost are the fixed, their selling costs are the fixed. So suppose if you are maintaining or fixed, maintaining at a standard cost, so you can have the standard costing method. So you have to specify the standard cost at the inventory, and the same will be valued for your item at the standard cost. So that also we will be going through. And the last is a monthly average cost, that is also the same thing like a weighted average, but monthly average cost will consider for the month, that is nothing for the monthly total inward value divided by the monthly inward quantity. So all this valuation method, we will be just navigating into the product, and we will be going and see how that valuation works in Tally.ERP 9. So basically, I will be going through the weighted average, FIFO, standard cost. Okay, so these are very important valuation method which company follows here. Okay, so I will be going for that. So let's start with our product walkthrough here. So I will start us how the thing valued here. So let's get started here. I'm just opening my Tally company here. Are you getting now the Tally screen here? Can you confirm on the chat box? Can you reply on the chat box? Tally company here. Okay, so we will be just going through the different valuation method. Now this is my tally data here. Okay, now let's say these are my inventory items. So I just going to the inventory info, stock item, alteration, and let's say this is my Dell Aspen desktop. So it's very important here for this valuation method. If you see here, I have selected a FIFO perpetual. You can see here, I selected the FIFO perpetual. Okay, it means the first in, first out, but perpetual. Perpetual, I have explained you, it will consider the rate if you have specified in the opening stock. You can see here, in the opening stock, I have specified 11,000 and 55,000. Now, I have already done some transactions here. So I just show you. So from gateway of tally, I just go display, inventory books, stock item, and Dell. Okay, and then I just open it. And let's say I just close here the session here. And I'm selecting a period here, 1st April to 30th April. Okay, now okay, so let's say now you are getting here. Okay, I have done some opening figures here, I have done some purchases, I have done some sales, and again I have done some purchases. If I select a period, okay, so I'm coming with this valuation method. So there is an opening rate, there are some purchases, there are some sales, and then there are some again purchases. Now, if you see here, I have selected for this particular item, my valuation method as FIFO perpetual, right? So you can see this is 5 quantity at the rate of 11,000, 55,000. This is 10 quantity, and then this is 2 quantity. So it's coming, it's 1,85,000. Okay, and these are the 17 numbers. So which is called getting here, that is 10,882.35. Okay, so first of all, I just reactivate my license. Since it got education, I'm just doing it at. Okay, now the license got activated now. Now let's see, I'm just again going to that particular product, display, inventory books, stock item, and let's say Dell desktop, and then suppose if I'm selecting a period 8th April. Okay, see, I have done some purchase here. I have done opening and with sale also. And then there is some purchase bill pending. Now, if you see here, what about the stock valuation it is taking here? The first in, first out. Then how we can see here? I just show you in the Excel. Okay, now you can see here, are you getting now Excel? Yeah, So I have inverted 5 quantity at the rate of 11,000, that is 55,000. Then I have a purchase bill, okay, 10 quantity, which is 1 lakh, and then 2, which is a purchase bill pending. Now, if I do the sum here, it's 1,85,000 with the rate. So if I divide by that, I'm getting here 10,882.35. But I am following here the FIFO perpetual. I'm not following the weighted average cost. Okay. Now, if you see here my outward, I have done my outward of 10 quantity, right? So as per FIFO method, the 5 quantity should be taken from my first opening stock. That is why I have taken 5 from 11,000, that is 55,000. And the balance 5 should be taken off my latest purchase. That is from 10 quantity. You can see here 10 quantity. Okay, so suppose this 5, I just do that. So this 5 I have taken from my this opening stock. And then 5 I have taken from my latest purchase. So this 10 I have sold it. Okay. Now the balance is how much? If I sold 17, total is inward quantity is 17, and if I sold 10, the balance is 7 quantity, right? So you can see here the 7 quantity. So if the 5 which I have sold, that is already sold, okay, now the 5 would be from the balance of 10, so that is why 5 into 10, 50,000, and then 2 which is from this latest quantity, that is from the GRN, or what we can say as the purchase bill pending, so that is 2, 15, 30,000. And if I do the total here and the 7, it gives me the valuation as 11,428.57. So have you understood that it has taken, first of all, the outward from the my opening inward quantity and the outward from my latest purchase quantity, and the balance it is taken into the consideration, which is working as a FIFO perpetual. So this 5 quantity is taken from the this 10 latest purchase at the rate of 10,000, 50,000, and the balance 2 quantity has been taken from my purchase bill pending here. So total 7 quantity, the rate which is coming is 11,428.57. Now we will just see in our tally how it is showing here. So you can see here 11,428.57, which is showing the same valuation which I have shown you in the Excel. Okay, now even if I've done the purchase bill pending here, so suppose if I done the purchase bill pending here, my value will be the same, 11,428.57. I'm just again going to my Excel. I will show you again that's Excel, and you can check it. Yes, it is same, 11,428.57. You can see here 11,428.57. So in this way, it calculates the FIFO perpetual by this method. So it takes into the consideration of the first in, first out, and if you have selected FIFO perpetual, so it takes the opening quantity also. So very important here. So whenever the user or the organization is going for the FIFO, so please we recommend you to select the FIFO perpetual. Correct. So this is what about the FIFO. Now let's say I'm going to the second item where I have selected the average cost. So let's see, I'm going to a tally again here. Yeah, so I selected a Lenovo desktop. So I'm just going to the inventory info, stock item, and then I am selecting Alter Lenovo H520 desktop. Now you can see here, for this I have selected a valuation method as average cost. You can see it, average cost. Correct. Average cost will treat like a weighted average cost, that is total inward value divided by total inward quantity. So I selected here, I have done the transaction. I will show you that. So display inventory book stock item, Lenovo Edge 520 desktop. And I will enter it, select the period, let's say from 1st April to 20th April. Now you can see here, I have an opening rate, I have a purchase, I have a rejection outward also, and then I have a sales transaction. Correct. So you can see here, if I do here, the total inward value, which is 22 numbers, and the total inward quantity, which is 355,000. Now, I just again to go with my Excel sheet calculation and we'll check here whether what valuation it has been picking up. And the same thing, the 10 numbers which I have sold it. So now I will go my Excel sheet here. So you can see here, this is the second method, weighted average cost 5, 10, 12. This is my opening, which we can say is opening. This is my purchase. This is again my purchase here. This is my rejection out, which I have done it. Okay. So if you see 5, 10, 12, 15, and this is 22 quantity, which has been showing as 355. So what is the formula for the weighted average cost? If you see here, is nothing, but what we can say is total inward value. Total inward value and what upon divided by total quantity. Correct. So if I divide the 355,000 divided by 22, I am getting here 16,136. Now I have sold 10 quantity, but as if you see here, weighted average cost or average cost will is more correlate only with respect to inward. It is not correlate with the outward. So 16,136 is my, what we can say as my valuation, right? Now I have sold 10 quantity. You can see here 10 quantity I have sold. So 5 and the balance what has been there. So 22 minus 10, I'm just again going into the tally here. Okay, so if I see my tally here, the 10 quantity I have sold here, you can see the balance is 12 quantity. So 22 minus 10, that is 12 quantity. But if you see the valuation, whatever is taken, 16,136 is the same has been taken for the valuation here. 16,136, that is total inward value divided by total inward quantity, which will give my rate per unit. And that is multiplied with my closing rate. So this is happening in case of weighted average cost. Okay, so this is very clear to you. So we have gone through the second valuation method. Now I will select for the third valuation. Let's say we have gone through or we have seen FIFO perpetual. We have seen this one. That is what we can say, weighted average cost. And now I will show you what is the use of zero cost and the standard cost. So let's say some of my atom, let's say electrical ion, right? This is my home appliances. Now here I will select a valuation here. Okay, let's say at zero cost. Suppose this is my capital assets. Okay, or this is my service item, whatever may be the things. So this is very important. You can see here costing method is very important here because valuation will depend upon this costing method and not the market valuation method. So all your valuation comes by selecting this costing method. Okay, and I have a 100 numbers, 2500. Okay. Now I will do one transactions here. Further, if I don't need such valuation to be reflected in my profit and loss account. Okay. Now suppose I will do some transactions here. I am selecting invoice number, date, I'm selecting party name. Okay, I'm selecting a purchase. Let's say batteries, whatever may be, and it's actually I have selected an item. So we have selected again. I'm just going here. One minute, what item we have selected? Just I'm reminding here. Yeah, electrical iron, which is under the home appliances. Okay. So let's say I'm doing a transactions. Okay, I'm selecting a party here. Then purchase or home appliances. One minute, I just check it. Okay, let's say purchase washing machine, or here we can say home appliances. Okay, no issue. And then I have iron, electrical iron. Okay, enter. I'm selecting a go down 10 quantity. Let's say it's 3000 rupees. Okay, and I'm selecting an item. Now if I just go here to see the impact of such an entry, and I will go to the profit and loss account, okay, and I will see closing stock. If I see here home appliances, now this is coming as electrical iron with no valuation. You can see here valuation is not coming, only quantity is reflecting. Why? Because I have selected the valuation as zero cost. You can see here I have selected here zero cost. So this is applicable in case of your fixed assets, in case you are service items where you do not want to value that. Now suppose even if you do not want to show the quantity, then you have an option here that is treat all purchases consumed. Just select it, save it, refresh that entry. I'm refreshing that entry. Now if you can see here, so treat all purchases consumed, I'm selecting here. So you can see here that 100 quantities of opening, but the 10 and maintain, which has become value zero. So that's very important, where you do not need even the quantity to be reflected. That also you can be done with this option. So what I have done, I have just done it, treat all purchases consumed. So this is very useful, because many times the user comes with such a scenario, or the organization comes with such a scenario where he maintains the fixed assets inventory, or where he maintains the services items inventory like repairing, AMC services. Okay, and in that case, okay, and they do not want to value and even the quantity, then this option is very important, that is at zero cost. So I have done it at zero cost. And even I have done it with treat all purchases consumed, so that inward and output will become zero and will not show any value. Now this quantity has been showing only because of the opening. Okay, so this is very important here. In case you want to go for the zero cost and where it has to be applied, that also I have explained to you. Now some company follows the standard cost. So let me take an example, floor tile. Okay, now this is an example of floor tile. Now where the company follows the standard cost. Now here there is an option of standard rates. You can see here standard rates. Now suppose the company is following the fixed purchase rate, or let's say fixed selling price rate, then he can apply this standard rates. So this option comes when we press F12. You can see F12 here, and then there is an option here, enable standard rates for stock item. Yes. Okay, so I just press yes here, and I can apply here, let's say from 30th April, or let's say from 1st April, my valuation should be for the styles is, let's say, 5,600. Okay, in this way, I can do it. Even for selling price, I can do it. And very important here, the costing method, I will change here and I will select here standard cost. In this way, I will select here, I will do that transaction. Now let's see, I'm doing that one transaction here, enter here, supply invoice number. Okay, now here, let's say 2nd April. Okay, and then I will apply here this one. Then this, okay, tiles. Okay, and then I will just go here, floor tile, not applicable, main location of Mumbai, whatever you selected here. See, you can see here, the rate is automatically capturing here because I have entered in the standard cost. So very important here, standard cost. Very important here. There is one query from Mr. Bhavnik. How we can record a webinar? Sir, we are already having a recorded, or whatever the webinar we record, we have a recorded webinar. If you need it, we can definitely send you the recorded webinar, because during this webinar itself, the process is auto webinar process is there. So auto recording webinar is there. So you don't worry, you don't do anything recording here. If you need a webinar of recorded of this today's webinar, definitely we will send you by mail or a link, and then you can refer it. So you don't need to record any webinar, because whatever the webinar is conducting today in the back end, the okay, Mr. Bhavnik. Okay, Mr. Bhavnish, it's clear. Just reply on the chat box. Okay, so we'll just continue here. So we continue here, and you can see here, I have selected from this particular item, the standard cost. So you can see 5,600, which I have mentioned in the inventory, is automatically capturing here. Okay, in this way, I'm selecting here, enter here. Now, okay, entry book stock item, if I say floor, you can see here, the edition, it will capture. Sure, standard rate, the 5,60,000. Let's say if I'm selling here any transaction, I will do one transaction here. If I'm selling here transaction here, let's say I'm doing a sales transaction here. Okay, Mr. Mohammed Zakir Hussain, definitely we will send you the recorded webinar. Since the internet connection is very slow, no issue, we will send you. Okay. Now in this way, I selecting here. Now in this way, if you see, I have done this and one sale transaction. Now I will just open here full trial. And if you see the valuation method, okay. So you can see the valuation, what is capturing is 5,600, which is a standard rate, which I have done it. So this is very important here. It is capturing the standard rate valuation, because I have selected here the standard cost. The same rate is very important here, so it's captioned here. Many times the user comes with such a difficulty that even after doing all such things, it is their valuation does not match with their books, and then again they faces such a problem. So in the meanwhile, we have whatever the rate you need to put or you need to have, and the same will get reflected in your balance sheet closing stock valuation. So this is very important in case of an alternative solution where you want to own stock and with your system stock. So for that also, we just sometimes recommend to use that to have the standard cost. Okay, so this is very important. So we have seen three different types of valuation method here. So one, we have seen the FIFO perpetual, the second, the weighted average cost, and the third, which we have seen, the standard cost method. The fourth, we have seen the zero cost, and the rest you can practice yourself, or the rest you can check in your live data what valuation and why, whether that valuation is capturing the same value or not. So whatever I explained is based on some formulas. Okay, so in this way, and the functionality of the Tally here. So in this way, they are the different valuation method, and Tally computes the proper valuation, and it's showing the correct valuation as per this valuation whatever you selected here. So that's very important here. Now many times the users ask us, what about the cost of sales? So many times they say, what is COGS or cost of goods sold? They need an information. For that, I'm just going from Gateway of Tally, and I will go to the profit and loss account. So if you see here we get the GP and the GP loss or net loss. But if someone asks about what is the cost of goods sold, then we have a reply here, and Tally also provides that information. Just press F12 here. You can see press F12 in the profit and loss account. Just press F12. Show vertical profit and loss account. You can see show vertical profit and loss, and you can get here the information about the cost of sales. You can see the cost of sales here. I just again show you the cost of sales. So you can see here the cost of sales here. It's very important here, the cost of sales. So you can see here the COGS, or what we can say is the cost of sales, is coming here. You can check here the cost of sales. It is nothing but the opening stock plus purchase less closing stock. So you can see the value is deriving here by adding here, and you can get the cost of goods sold. So many times the organization or your auditor asks, or you have a query that whether Tally provides the cost of goods sold or the cost of the sales. So that information you get in the profit and loss account. So I just explain you again here. Okay. So that method you get it in here. So very important here. So that is very important here. So we get from profit and loss account, enter F12 and show vertical profit and loss account, and then you press enter here. You can get here the cost of goods sold. So you can see here cost of sales you are getting here. So that's very important here. So cost of goods sold, you get an information from here. Okay, so you can see cost of sales here. So opening plus closing, sorry, opening at purchases and the closing stock. So in this way, you can select, you can have the cost of goods sold or the cost of sales information. So this is all about our valuation method, and the what we can say as the cost of goods sold here. Now for any queries, so for any queries, or whether you are facing any difficulty in inventory valuation, or still you are facing the difficulties in from Tally stock valuation, you are free to contact us at the below numbers given mentioned in the slides. So you can just check the slides here. We have mentioned the numbers here. So even our email ID, and then suppose the all the lines are busy, you can WhatsApp it also. The number of the WhatsApp is also been mentioned here, and whom and the attendance who has, and the audience who has requested for the recorded webinar, definitely we will send them. Okay, we will send them the link, and they can see the recorded webinar also. We have a new event page which we have launched, www.soindia.com/events. So for any upcoming webinars, workshops, events, and even for videos or any updates, please visit this website and log in here and register for our upcoming webinars also. So it's very important, just visit our new event page here, www.soindia.com/events. So this is all about the inventory valuation. Is any other queries you can ask me? Yes.